Am I audible? Should I start? Okay, fine. Okay. Hi, my name is Dr. Aishwarya, and today I'm going to speak about the treatment related to sciatica. Okay, fine. So before I start my lecture, I just like to thank Alpha Cure Physiotherapy for giving me this opportunity to conduct the live lecture of sciatica. Before I proceed further for the sciatica treatment, I would just like to demonstrate the test as described by Dr. Monica Gohil yesterday on the live video. There are three tests demonstrate to you. The first is the SLR test. Second is the LASIK sign. That is a modification of SLR, and the third one is a piriformis test. Fine. So I'm just going to demonstrate the live with my model. Fine. Okay. Fine. I'm just demonstrating the test. I'm just demonstrating the test. The first one is SLR. That is straight leg raise. Fine. Fine, I'm just starting. First, stand at the distal end of the patient's leg. Am I audible? Fine. Flex the hip and hold one hand at the knee joint, another one at the knee joint. Fine. Am I clear? Am I visible? Just tell me whether I'm visible or not. Everybody is able to see my model? Everybody is able to see? So I will continue. Fine. First test, straight leg raise test, the number one test. Again, I'm repeating. Hold one hand in the ankle joint. Another one at the knee joint. Fine. Now just flex the hip with the knee extended. Okay. Now just take the hip to the 70 degree. Fine. 70 degree. Now if the patient is experiencing the pain at this range, fine, or below 70 degree, that is 60 degree to 30 degree. If the patient is experiencing the pain between these ranges, fine, between these ranges, the pain will be the radicular pain at the anterior of the thigh, the calf, okay, and as, fine, am I clear, okay. If the patient is experiencing the radicular pain at the posterior of the thigh and the leg, fine, that will indicate the sciatic nerve compression with the low back pain. Fine, this is a positive SLR. Fine, I will just repeat the test again. The pain I'm describing will be the radicular pain radiating from the posterior of the thigh to the leg, to the lower leg. Fine. The pain will be kind of a sharp shooting pain. The patient can experience some kind of a tingling sensation as well as some kind of a burning sensation. Depends on the severity of the compression of the nerve. Fine. There are various kinds of symptoms we see in a patient. Either a sharp shooting radicular pain or else burning sensation at the posterior of the thigh as well as the leg. Fine. And sometimes the pain is very much minimal. Depends on the severity of the compression of the sciatic nerve. I will repeat the test again. Fine. Hold one hand at the ankle joint. Another one at the knee joint. Flex the hip to the 70 degree. The patient is experiencing radicular pain from the posterior thigh to the leg joint. Fine, that indicates a positive SLR test. I hope everybody is able to understand what I am trying to say. Please reply me with the yes. Am I clear with the first test? Fine. I will go on to the second test now. That is Lasik sign. That is a modification of the straight leg raise test. Lasik sign is similar to the SLR test, but please don't get confused between the two tests. Fine. I will just show you. The same. Hold one hand at the ankle joint, another hand at the knee joint. Flex the hip to the 70 degree. Flex the hip to the 70 degree. The patient will experience the sharp shooting radicular pain or the tingling sensation from the posterior of the thigh to the posterior leg, along with the pain at the SI joint. That is a positive Lasik sign. The difference between the two of them is, in the positive Lasik sign, the patient might experience the SI joint pain or the pain at the L4 and L5 region. Again, depending upon the severity of the compression of the sciatic nerve. Fine. Usually in the daily practices, we are performing the straight leg raise test, as it is easier to demonstrate, as well as it is a faster method of diagnosing the sciatic nerve impingement. Fine. Now, I will proceed on the third test, piriformis test. Fine. Again, it is used to evaluate the sciatic nerve compression. These all tests are used to evaluate the sciatic nerve compression. Fine. The severity will depend again on the diagnosis. Either you can refer the MRI. MRI is the best way to diagnose the severity of the compression of the L4 and L4, L5 and S1 disc compression. Fine. Now, the patient will go on the sideline. Now, I will passively flex the hip to the 60 degree. From 60 to 70 degree, I will ask the patient to flex the hip, or I will passively flex the hip. Fine? Am I visible? Is it visible? No. I am demonstrating again. I hope everybody is able to see this. And I will just... Fine. Am I visible now? Fine. Fine. 70 degree. The important thing is the patient should lie at the edge of the bed. Fine. The patient should be at the edge of the bed. The patient should be at the edge of the bed. That is very important in piriformis test demonstration. Knee flexion should be between 20 to 30 degrees. Fine. Now, the important thing is, now I will just apply a downward pressure on the lateral part of the knee joint. I will apply a downward pressure on the lateral part of the knee joint. Fine. The positive piriformis test indicates the pain at the lateral part of the thigh with the tightness of the piriformis. When I will apply the downward pressure on the lateral part of the knee joint, the patient will experience a stretch pain or a mild sensation or the tightness of the piriformis, or else the patient can experience a sharp shooting pain at the lateral part of the thigh, again depending upon the severity. So the pain on the lateral part of the thigh will indicate a positive piriformis test, and that will show that the sciatic nerve is compressed. फाइन, एम आई क्लियर विद द 3 टेस्ट? एम आई क्लियर? ओके फाइन. नाउ डज एनीबडी हैव एनी डाउट्स रिगार्डिंग द 3 टेस्ट? एम आई ऑडिबल? एम आई क्लियर? एम आई विजिबल? ओके. ओके सॉरी. नाउ आई विल मूव फॉरवर्ड टू ट्रीटमेंट ऑफ द शियाटिका. फर्स्टली देर आर 2 मेथड्स, सर्जिकल एंड नॉन सर्जिकल. यूजुअली नॉन सर्जिकल मेथड इज प्रिफर्ड बाय सर्टेन डॉक्टर्स. फाइन, सर्जिकल मेथड इज यूजुअली डन इफ द पेन परसिस्ट फॉर मोर देन 6 to 8 वीक्स. Fine, if the pain persists for more than 6 to 8 weeks with the symptoms including the patient is unable to walk properly, patient is facing difficulty in activities of daily living, or else in severe or more severe or critical symptoms, the patient is unable to get up from the bed. That is, the patient is bedridden. Yeah, I will explain you the difference between the first and second test. First, First, let me finish with the treatment. Then again, I will, at the last, when I will explain about the overview, that time I will just tell you again the difference between the first and the second test. Fine? Just let me finish with the treatment first. Yeah, I will surely repeat. First, let me finish with the treatment of sciatica. Again, I am going to repeat the test. Fine? Okay. So usually the surgical method is done when the pain persists for more than 6 to 8 weeks and the patient is unable to walk, unable to get up. There is severe pain on the low back area, as well as there is sharp shooting pain on the leg, on the affected leg, as well as the patient is unable to walk properly. Then the orthopedics advise for the surgery. And after surgery also, the back pain is not resolved. The back pain is forever. The back pain does not get resolved. Post-surgery also, we are giving the physiotherapy to the patients for the lifetime. Fine. So, there are certain surgical methods I will go through in a short way, because I have to just interpret the exercises in a brief. So, I won't tell you much about the surgical procedures. Surgical procedures are usually done to relieve the leg pain, the inflammation, as well as the pain related to the compression, the severe low back pain, so that the patient is able to do his activities of daily living. Certain spine decompression surgeries are done, such as laminectomy foraminotomy. Micro discectomy is also done along with that. I will just repeat again. Micro discectomy is done. Lumbar decompression surgeries are performed, such as laminectomy, foraminotomy, and discectomy. Fine. These are the names of the surgeries. I won't go brief in this. Fine. Now, certain non-surgical methods. These are very important methods. Before I proceed to the exercises, I will just tell you about the other non-surgical methods which are used. Fine. First are the medications. Very important, the medications, both the prescriptions given by the therapist as well as the over-the-counter medications are given to the patient, such as the non-steroid anti-inflammatory drugs, oral steroids are given, and certain opioid analgesics are given, such as a tramadol, and certain anticonvulsant medications are also given. Second is chiropractic therapy. You would have heard about the chiropractic therapy. Usually spinal manipulation is done in this therapy, and this therapy is performed to improve the alignment of the spinal cord. So, chiropractic therapy is usually used in sciatica. sciatic pain or the low back pain due to so that the alignment of the spine is improved, nothing else. Only the alignment of the spine is improved, so the circular practice is done. Third is the massage therapy. Massage therapy is done to increase the blood circulation as well as to relax the tighten muscles. But I will recommend this if the patient is having severe low back pain, and that if that is radiating pain, I will advise you not to tell the patient to go for a massage therapy, cause that might aggravate the pain. That might aggravate the pain. There is no significance, but that might aggravate the pain. So it's better to tell the patient not to undergo a massage therapy. The fourth one is lumbar therapeutic. Lumbar therapeutic injections are given, such as the epidural steroids. Fine, certain corticosteroid injections are given to relieve the pain for 4 to 6 months. The patient may not experience the pain for 6 months, but post 6 months the pain might arise. The sciatic pain might arise. And in 80% of the patients which I have seen, the pain occurs after 4 to 5 months of taking. Relieve the paraspinal muscle spasm or any pain related to muscle tightness, or you know, usually in athletes or in people having a spasm or certain kind of the blood circulation is less in the spinal cord or muscles, paraspinal muscles, then cupping therapy is used. Now the sixth one is dry needling. Even dry needling, people are doing this. Dry needling, usually the needle penetrates the skin and treats the underlying muscles, which triggers the points for the management of the neuromuscular pain and movement impairments. Seventh one is the hydrotherapy. Even hydrotherapy is very much effective. Fine, you can hydrotherapy is usually performed inside the water or a small pool. Okay, hydrotherapy usually helps in strengthening of the muscles, strengthening of the joints. It also helps in removing the tightness of the muscle if prolonged hydrotherapy is done, as well as it helps in improving the mobility and the flexibility. Now this non-surgical methods, my topic of non-surgical method is done. Now I will proceed for the exercises given for the sciatic nerve pain. And these exercises are very basic. And along with these exercises, certain methods which I already told you before, that is a dry needling or cupping therapy, can be done along with these exercises. But these exercises should be recommended by each and every physio to the patient, so that patient is able to perform as a home program also. Fine. So I will just demonstrate you with the exercises. The first exercise is spine extension exercises. I will ask the patient to lie down on a prone position. Am I visible? Fine. Am I clear now? Am I visible? Fine. Remove the pillow. First one is spine extension exercises. I will ask the patient to lie on a prone position, hands extended on the sideways. Relax. Fine. Now, this is a starting position. Now, I will ask the patient to flex the elbow.
Yes.
Now slowly I will tell the patient to extend the spine upwards. One important thing to remember is make sure the patient does not extend his spine from the pelvis. The pelvis movements, the pelvic movement should not be compensated in this. Not this way. I will show you the wrong way. This is the wrong way. The pelvis should not be lifted up. Go down. Yes. Fine. This is a spine extension. Fine. If the patient is experiencing more tightness, I will tell the patient to flex the elbow. This way. Yes, this way. Fine. This way. Now, I will tell the patient to hold this position for 10 seconds. Relax. This has should be done for the 10 times. 10 repetitions, 10 counts. Fine. Am I clear with the first exercise? Can you reply if possible? Okay. Second one is a straight leg raise exercise. Patient will lie supine.
Supine lying position.
Patient will be in the supine lying position. Patient will be in the supine lying position. Fine. Now, one leg will be flexed. The right leg will be flexed. Shoulder will be extended. I'm sorry, I'm not that much. Am I visible? Am I visible? Okay, fine. Okay. The right leg will be flexed, fine, and the left leg will be extended, sorry, the left hip will be flexed, right knee will be flexed, the left hip will be flexed along with the knee extension. I will ask the patient to perform this movement, fine. Now just raise your leg, okay. It depends on the tightness of the hamstrings. There are certain patients who cannot flex their hip beyond 30 degrees or 20 degrees. So it depends on the tightness of the hamstrings. Fine. Just extend your leg. Okay. Now this patient is able to hold this position at the 60 degree. Fine. So I will tell the patient to hold this position for 5 seconds. 5 counts 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. Again, I will repeat for another leg. Now the left hip and the knee is flexed and the right hip is extended. Now I will ask the patient to flex the hip along with the knee extension. Go down. And hold this position for 5 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. One thing to remember is when the patient is flexing his hip joint, make sure the patient does not flex his knee joint due to the tightness of the hamstrings. Fine? The patient should purely extend his knee along with the hip extension. It depends on the tightness of the hamstrings as well. If the patient is unable to lift his extend his hip beyond 30 degree, make sure you make the hold the position in that range itself. Don't go beyond that. The knee should not be flexed. Make sure. Now, the third exercise is spine flexion exercises. spine flexion exercises, third one. Hands are extended. Knee flexion along with the hip flexion. Fine. I will ask the patient to hold his leg with both of his hands. And then the patient will flex his hip. Flex the fine. Hold the position for 10 counts. 10 times each leg. Initially, you can go for 5 repetitions. Gradually, 10 repetitions, 10 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Relax. Same for another leg. Relax. This is a self-stretching for gluteus as well. Glutes, self-stretching of gluteus muscle. Fine. Now the fourth exercise is bridging. Bridging is very simple, yet depends on completely on the pain on the lower back. The patient is having severe pain on the lower back and the pain hands extended. Now I will ask the patient to lift up his pelvis. Now again this position will be hold for 10 seconds and relax. Initially 5 repetitions, gradually 10 repetitions, 10 seconds, 10 counts. Now the fifth one is prone leg extension. The patient will lie on the prone side. I'm sorry for the interruption in between. Now the fifth one is prone leg extension exercise. Patient will lie on the prone position. Now I will ask the patient to extend his hip with the knee extended. The knee should not be flexed. Make sure the hip is not abducted. Initially the patient might experience stretch pain, so initially I will tell you to hold for 5 counts 10 times. 5 counts, 10 times, then progress to 10 counts, 10 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Relax. Make sure the knee is not flexed and make sure the hip is not abducted. Till now, I have shown you 5 exercises. First is spine extension. Second one is straight leg raise. Third is a spine flexion exercise. Fourth one is bridging and the fifth one is prone leg extension. Sixth one is abdominal curl up exercises. That is usually done. Again, patient will be in a supine lying position. I hope I am visible. Am I visible? Okay, am I visible? Please reply with the yes. Am I visible? Am I visible? Okay. The sixth one is the abdominal curl up exercise. I will ask the patient to flex both the knees. Hands will be near the cervical region. below the atlas and the axis. Now, I will ask the patient to flex his shoulder, spine. The patient will flex his spine. Wait. Hold this way. Just clasp your fingers and hold your posterior side of the head region. Now, the patient will flex his spine. Make sure the patient is not flexing his cervical spine. The patient should not experience the pain in the cervical region, make sure, while performing this exercise. Now, initially hold 7 counts, gradually 10 to 15 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, relax. Fine? Am I clear with the 6 exercises? Am I clear? These are the basic 6 exercises which I have demonstrated. There are a lot more exercises, but it depends on the again the severity of the compression of the nerve, as well as the severity of the back pain, as well as the pathology of the back issue. Depending on that, there are changes in the exercises. These are the basic 6 exercises which you can give to the patient having a sciatic pain. There are other back pain pathologists, but the exercises are going to differ, because in some of them you can't give exercises in which the flexion synergy patterns are used, and in certain of them you can't give extension synergy patterns. So depends on the pathology of back pathology. Fine. Now I will just proceed for certain lower limb stretching exercises which are very, very important, that we give this to each and every patient who are complaining of normal back pain or moderate back pain or sciatic back pain related to sciatic nerve. Fine. Usually the lower limb muscles, tightness of the lower limb muscles usually they aggravate the back pain in many condition, in many people, usually above 30 or 35 years of age, or who are physically inactive, or who are having a sedentary lifestyle, or who are having diabetes, obesity. Fine. So stretching on the muscles is very, very important. Yeah. Make sure if the position of the therapist is aligned with the patient, and don't overuse your muscles. Don't make your muscles fatigued, because it can cause injury to the therapist as well. So make sure your position is also aligned with the patient. Don't stress yourself while performing the stretching exercises on the patient. First, make yourself comfortable and then proceed for the exercises further. Fine. First one is the hamstring stretching. Fine. Patient is in supine lying position. Hold one ankle with one hand. Another one. Am I visible? Hold one hand at the posterior part of the ankle. Another one at the posterior part of the knee. Just flex your hip and make sure the ankle is supported by your shoulder, so that your shoulder is relaxed. Fine. Another hand at the knee joint. Fine. Now the leg of नाउ
वर्बल बताइए
फ्लेक्स वन नी नाउ जस्ट अडक्ट योर हिप the knee externally rotate the hip internally rotate the knee stabilize the opposite pelvis फॉर कॉर्डिसेप्स स्ट्रेच द पेशेंट इज इन द प्रोन लाइन पोजिशन फ्लेक्स वन नी प्लांटर फ्लेक्स द एंकल एंड जस्ट गिव द स्ट्रेच इफ द